Okay, the link will be provided. Okay, it will be having one or two questions only. I will give only two questions just to get an idea whether you are familiar with the examination process or not. Okay, I'll be telling that through channels. I'll tell in class. Okay, through channel is very easy. I'll upload it in channel and you can go through that one. Okay, so I haven't prepared the examination for you. Okay,
sir, watch the timing of exam.
See here, you can appear anytime, 3 p.m. onwards till 9 p.m. Okay. So just to know whether you are familiar with the examination process or not, okay?
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, if you appear channel, then sir, how it will work?
Okay, channel I will tell you, okay? So it will be uploaded. Today I am uploading in CIsoft only, okay? Mainly you will be getting in CIsoft, okay? Online examination and classwise notes. So you can get the link from anywhere, online examination or classwise notes, okay? So what I was saying, so always check. So you see, for example, your examination begin at 9:30. For example, it begin at 9:30. 1 minute, everyone mute yourself. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, so for example, your examination begins at 9:30. Check it 15 to 20 minutes earlier whether the link is available or not. Okay, always check it whether the link is available or not. If no, then text to the subject teacher immediately. Okay, text to your subject teacher on WhatsApp immediately. Okay, if you are not getting response within 5 minutes, do call. Okay, so always check 15 to 20 minutes earlier if the link is available or not in CIsoft online examination or classwise notes. Okay, in channel there will be few teachers may provide in channel, but mostly it won't be provided in channel. The main reason is, since through mobile this option is not available to upload in channel. Okay, only through laptop we can upload in channel. Okay, so most of the teacher won't be able to upload it in channel. Okay, so
sir,
it is, yes
sir, they will provide link on WhatsApp also?
No, it won't be provided on WhatsApp. It will be provided in CIsoft. So two things you have to do: always update your CIsoft, keep it updated, and update, keep your Microsoft Teams as well updated. Okay, so today I'll be providing the link in CIsoft only. Okay,
sir, how will you get CIsoft in a PC?
Once again, ask Lucian.
Sir, how many questions will you
get? Okay, how many questions? 1 minute. Yes, Lucian.
Sir, how we will get CIsoft on laptop?
On laptop, how will you get? No, you don't require that. Okay. See here. The thing is, CIsoft app is not available. Okay. The CIsoft app is not available. Okay. If you install emulator, it consumes lot of your RAM. Okay, and mainly if your RAM is around 2 GB or 4 GB, it will be hard to run emulator. Okay, it will take a lot of time to load emulator first, then in that you will open the CIsoft app. Okay, that is fine. See, a CIsoft, it's the app, its desktop version is not available. That is, we do not have the app for the desktop. Okay, so there's one link, like I use that link, so it's easy. I'll provide you that link in your group. Okay,
the link is itk.cst/online.
Yes, yes, that's it. So I'll provide that link in your WhatsApp. Okay, you can check that one, open that one, and you can log in through that. Okay,
sir.
And sir, what, yes, password we have to put in it?
CIsoft, mainly CIsoft. You already have got the password. If no, go in your profile section. Okay, there's a way, I think, you can create a password there. In CIsoft, you can create a password.
Sir, we can create, sir, automatically our password, what we want to create.
Yes, you can create that. I think it's in profile.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, or just give me 1 minute. Let me bring the phone and let me show you, okay? Just give me 1 minute.
Okay, sir.
Okay. The link for the desktop version I will provide. Okay, you can bookmark that, or you can keep it somewhere. Okay, it is opening CSoft. Sometimes it takes a lot of time, CSoft. Okay.
So, sir.
Yes.
Sir, how many questions you will give in test?
Today, today's test is just to know whether you are able to appear or not. Okay. So I'll be giving only two or three questions. Okay. Just to know whether you are able to attend or not. That's it. Okay. If you are in grade zero, don't mind it. Okay. If you get zero, that means you haven't studied. That's all. Okay. Don't mind whatever marks you get, but you must be familiar to attend the, that is, you must be familiar with the examination process. Okay. So just attempt those questions and submit it. Okay. It's just to know whether you are able to attend or not. I'm not going to see your marks. I'm going to see the names only, whether you are able to attend the paper or not. Okay. So,
sir.
Yes.
Sir, in that, if it asks to sign in, sir, that which password you have to use? We not have to use the Teams password. Teams new created password. We have that password okay, you not have to use.
One minute. If you are logging in CSoft, you have to use CSoft password. Okay, that is for CSoft. Okay. If you are appearing for the examination, you have already got the link. You are clicking the link. As you click the link, form will appear. Okay. If password has already been saved by default. If no, the Microsoft logo will appear. See, just a minute, I'll tell. Okay. The logo will appear, Microsoft, and it will ask for you to enter to. It will ask you to enter the username. Okay. Username that is being provided by the school. Okay. Your name, then 67@sendmaryschoolseeker.org. That is username. Okay. You have to enter that one. And later on, as you click submit, it will ask for your password. Enter the password that you have changed. You already changed the password. Just one minute. You have to enter that password and the form will appear. Okay. This is clear. Okay. Now they just ask.
Sir, I have done sir like this.
What is the timing?
Okay. See, there is no time limit. I'll upload at 3. You may get before that as well. Okay. Around 3, you can check it. Here, I'm going to upload in CSoft only today. CSoft only. Okay. Channel
sir,
whenever
to,
we are
there. Sir, up to today? 9 p.m. the test will. Sir, up to yes. 9 p.m. the test will be there.
Yes, it will be there. You can appear anytime. It will take hardly take 2 or 3 minutes. Okay. It will take hardly 2 or 3 minutes.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, I have entered my sir username and then it asked for password, sir. Password I entered, but sir, it was saying that the password was incorrect.
Incorrect. If it is saying like this, check once whether you have done entered correctly. That is, whether it is what you say, uppercase or the lowercase. Okay.
Sir,
if it is still saying incorrect password, text to your class teacher. Okay. Whenever it says incorrect password, text to your class teacher immediately. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, the password that Geeta ma'am provided, sir, the school provided that, sir, I have written, but sir, it was saying that it was incorrect.
See, the school, the password which the school has provided, you have seen as you entered the password first time, it has asked you to change the password. And you have changed the password at that time. Okay. So the password which you have set at the time, that is the password for the Teams for you now.
But in which section in Microsoft will the link appear?
In which section? It will appear in online examination as well as in class-wise notes. Okay. It will appear in online examination as well as in class-wise notes. Okay. See here, I'm going to make one message. I will text it on WhatsApp to your groups. Okay. In there, it will be written that the link will be available in CSoft, online examination, and class-wise notes. So if you are not getting the link in online examination, you can check in class-wise notes. So, and every exam, when it starts, check it once 20 minutes earlier. At least check 20 minutes earlier once, whether the link is available or not. Okay. Whether the link is available or not. Okay. Always check it once. In CSOft, I don't know where it is. Settings.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, if in laptop we open the CSOft, then sir, only one time we have to write our username and password, then it will be saved only.
Yeah, there's an option to save it. You can save it. You can save it username or password. Like, for example, my username and my password is saved in Google account. My username and password CSOft is saved in Google account. So when I enter the details, that is send my school in the top, you'll be getting three or four options like this. School, okay, then like this. Four options will be there. Four blanks will be there. First one will ask you school. So as you click here, three will open. Second convent school like this. Send my school, you will enter from there. Next one, it will ask you whether you are a teacher or admin, super admin, or a student, okay, or a parent. So you'll enter here. Now it will ask you username and then password. Okay. So as you click them, the browser, it will automatically ask you whether you want to save it to the Google account or not. You can save it to the Google account. Next time, when you enter send my school, and here your parent as a parent, and as you click here, it will automatically show that do you want this password to be entered. As you click username and password, it will be automatically entered in desktop version. Okay. I do usually that one. Okay.
Sir, if you want, I can show you it that. Sir, in mine it asked that one blank in this parent, teacher, office, super admin, and next
okay,
name and password.
Okay, okay, the, just give me 1 minute. Let me show you as well. Okay. So if you are logged in through Gmail account, if it is saved in your Gmail account, automatically it will appear. Okay. Okay, I'm going to share the screen and you can see there.
Yes, I will share the screen, then we will see.
Okay, so for example, you are logging in here. This is the link. Okay, login form. You can see it.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now see here. It will appear like this. Now in the first one, login form. As you click, schools, send my school. Now second one, here, as a parent, you have to enter, okay? As a parent, you have to enter. I'm teacher, so I have to enter as a teacher, okay? You have to enter as a parent, okay? As I did, now as I click, it will say, should I enter this one? Yes, and login. So this is how it is going to appear, okay? You can check this one, okay? And all the YouTube videos are available here in US.
And sir, we have to do that from our phone only, that CSOft password.
CSOft password will be set through phone, yes. Like this here, I have entered 8 Lily. Here is the form link. 9 Daisy as well, as you click on it. Okay, it's centered there. Okay. You can see. So here's the link uploaded. Okay, this is clear. Is this clear now?
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Okay, 1 minute. Channel. Okay, channel, I will tell you on Friday. Okay. But it more mainly all the teachers are going to put the link in CSOft. Okay. Online examination and that one class-wise notes. Okay. So I will upload on channel as well. Okay. You can get it through channel as well. No issues. So that I will tell you on Friday. Okay.
So you tell on
when you will take test.
Today at 3 p.m. you can check once, okay? You can check once, okay? So see here, the thing is, as I upload the paper, I'll put the message in WhatsApp, okay? And you can appear anytime. During the day, any time you can appear, it will hardly take 2 or 3 minutes. I'm going to put only 2 or 3 questions, okay? It's just to know whether you are able to attend the paper or not. That's all, okay? So appear in that examination and submit, okay? Tomorrow is a holiday or not, okay? That message, I do not know at present, you will get. If there is a holiday, you are soon going to get the message from the school. And most probably 99.99%
just
chance.
Just to get the message.
Sir, what?
Yes.
It is
going to be a holiday. Only 0.001 chances that it may not be holiday, okay? You will get that message from school soon, okay?
It means that tomorrow it's...
Sir, but we are already at home. This is a kind of holiday only, sir. Then why holiday?
Yes.
You came in class if you
know. But if you are celebrating, you need holiday. Okay. Everyone like holidays. Yes or no?
Sir. You don't take leave on that cabin.
Sir, one more week of Hindi, please.
It's fine. I have spoken many words of Hindi in class if you find it. Okay. So is this fine? We have completed. Okay. Examination process, you all are clear with that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sub clear hai? Okay. So we can start now. Okay.
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Okay. So we can start our, now we can start the physics chapter. Okay. So examination around 3 I'll upload. Anytime you are free, just attend it. Okay? Just attend it. And don't submit just without looking anywhere. So always go through the questions, submit it. And see here, I'm not going to put the names. You don't have to enter the name in the examination. Okay? I'll just write the section you have to enter. That will be compulsory. Red mark will be there. Okay? With the section. So you have to enter the section. Without entering that, you won't be able to submit the paper. Okay? Enter the section and complete the questions. Your name is automatically going to be submitted since you are going to submit the paper through your ID. So your name will automatically appear along with your username and all the details will appear automatically. Okay. Okay. So Newton's first law we have discussed. According to the Newton's first law, there what is required to change the state?
Force.
A force is required. If a body is at rest, force is required to change its state. If body is at state of motion, in state of motion, that is if the body is moving with uniform motion, is in uniform, it means it is moving with uniform velocity. It means same direction with the same speed it is moving. And to change the speed or the direction or both, we require force. Or to stop, we require force. This was first Newton's first law. Okay. Now we are discussing Newton's second law. So we are just discussing the the framework we are discussing to reach Newton's second law. Okay. So in Newton's second law, we have discussed linear momentum. We have discussed linear momentum, that is body moving in a line, in a straight line, it is moving. Okay, one direction. Then we have discussed changing momentum. Changing momentum we have discussed. Till the force is applied, there will be changing momentum. The body is moving with some velocity, no force is acting, so same velocity. Momentum is there, but it's constant momentum. It's not varying. Now, as we applied force, change starts to take place. And this change happened till force is there. We remove the force, now no more change. Okay. So in that duration, change has taken place. There's a change in momentum from initial to final momentum. Understood? Initial momentum to final momentum. So we are going to study the rate of change of momentum. Rate of change of momentum today. Physics is very, very easy. If we understand, there is nothing to mug up. Momentum. Okay. We are going to study rate of change of momentum. So you can see the words. Momentum is there. Mv. Change means delta, rate means divided by t. Have you understood? Momentum is a change in momentum, rate means per unit time, per second, how it is changing. What is the change in per second? That we are going to discuss. Okay. So for example, we have a body of mass m.
voice is coming like.
Yes.
Yes, sir. It is your voice.
Sir, your voice is breaking in between.
No, sir, it's breaking.
No, sir, your voice is not clear.
Yes, sir, it is breaking.
Okay, is it clear? Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
If it is okay, so see, here two things I can do from here. Once I can mute myself, unmute, it becomes clear. Or else I reconnect them. Okay. Okay. So. Whenever it happens, even the slide will just let me know. Okay, voice. We are having a body of mass m. A body is there whose its mass is m. Okay. Now it is moving with velocity u. It is moving with velocity u. So mass of the body m kg. You can take initial velocity. Initial velocity is how much?
U.
Okay, it is moving with initial velocity. So no force is acting, it will continue to move with this initial velocity. Okay, now for example, here we applied the force. Okay, now we are applying force on the body. As the force is applied, what will happen to the velocity? Consider we are considering mass is not changing. We are considering force is applied, mass is not changing. We are assuming that mass is constant. It remains, mass remains constant throughout the journey or throughout the motion. Okay. So, if as force is applied, what will happen? Velocity will change. So, for example, at this moment, at this time, we started to apply the force. As we started to apply the force, u starts to change. This velocity starts to change. And at this moment, we remove the force. So, this is the time duration for which we have applied the force. For t seconds, we have applied the force. So, during these t seconds, there is change in velocity. During this t seconds, there is change in velocity. Do you remember something? Change in velocity. What does it represent?
Acceleration.
Acceleration. Yes. That is it. Rate of change of velocity.
Rate of change rate of velocity. Change.
Velocity is called as acceleration.
Acceleration.
Change in velocity per unit time. Okay. So here velocity starts to change. Now at this moment, we have removed the force. As we remove the force, now whatever velocity it has gained at this point. For example, it is v. So now this body will keep on moving with what velocity? V velocity?
V.
Okay. So what was the initial? Initial velocity. Final moment. Final velocity. V. Okay. Time taken for the change. Time taken is how much? T. Okay. Now, what will be the initial momentum before we have applied the force?
Mu.
Initial momentum. I'm writing P only. Okay. It is mu. What is final momentum?
Mv.
Mv.
This is final momentum. This change has taken place. How much time it has taken to change from this P to this P?
T
time it has. Okay. So change in momentum is how much?
T. Mv minus mu.
Final momentum minus initial momentum. Mv minus mu. M we can take common because here we have assumed that mass remains constant throughout the journey. Whether we apply the force, there has been no change in mass. We have assumed that. We have taken that assumption. Only change in velocity. M V minus U. Okay. This is change in momentum. And rate of change of momentum. Rate of change in momentum.
This M into V minus U upon T.
How much time? M V minus U upon T. Okay. What is this? M into V minus U upon T. What is this?
Minus U.
Acceleration.
Acceleration. Acceleration. Rate of change of momentum is equal to mass into acceleration. Okay. So what we can say? The rate of change in momentum of a body is equal to product of the mass and
acceleration.
Acceleration produced in the body. Okay, how this acceleration has been produced? When we applied the force. Understood? So, rate of change in momentum of a body is equal to product of the mass and acceleration produced due to the force applied. Okay, this is clear?
Yes.
And here, what we assume, the mass remains constant. Mass remains constant. That is, there is no change in mass. This is applicable only for when mass is constant. We have assumed that one. If there had been change in mass, then it will be m1 u upon and here will be m to u. Okay, so here we have made one assumption that mass remains constant. Okay, so on page number 65, the last paragraph, first column, last few lines are there, they are important. Okay, you can see the in pink box, rate of change of momentum equal to mass into acceleration. This is important, and these last few lines are there. The rate of change in momentum of a body is equal to product of the mass of the body and acceleration produced in the body due to that force. Okay, what is provided? What is the condition? Always remember that the mass of the body remains constant. This direction holds true only when we are taking mass as constant. It is not varying when the force is applied. Okay, this is clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Alternative method, it will take 1 minute. Okay, it's the same kind of we can go with the alternative method. That is, there's change in velocity. So initial momentum is, for example, we are taking v, mv. Okay, change in velocity, since there's change in momentum, will be what? M delta v. Delta v remains, delta v is final velocity minus initial velocity. Delta v represents change in velocity. Okay, then this change in taking place in delta t times divided by delta t. Delta p upon delta t equal to m. What is delta v upon delta t? Change in velocity is again acceleration. Okay. So first one is better. Okay, clear? This is clear to all? Okay. Now we'll compare Newton's first law and second law. Okay. Now we are going to compare Newton's first law and second law. Okay. In Newton's first law, what we have discussed? Newton's first law. Both with once.
If something is held rest, it will be motion if we apply force.
Okay, I'm reading it. A statement is given. According to Newton's first law of motion, if a body is in state of rest, if it is in state of rest, it will remain in rest. Okay, unless any force is applied. Till force is not applied, it will remain in rest. Unless any force is applied. Okay, now second part. What is the second part? If it is in state of motion, it will remain in the same state of motion. That is, it will move with the same speed in the same direction unless any force is applied. So what is the condition there? That is, force is required to change the state of the body. Yes or no? Or to bring change in the state of the body. A force is required. Okay. So in Newton's first law, we have discussed only this, that a force is required to bring the change in the body. That is, to bring the change in the state of the body. Okay. In Newton's first law, we have only discussed that force is required. So it's kind of qualitatively we can speak that is, force is required. How much is required? That we do not know. We can't measure through the Newton's first law. Okay. Newton's first law just tells that a change in state of the body, a force is required. So force is the requirement for the change in the body state. Okay, but in second law, what we are measuring, we are bringing that the force required, that is proportional to the, or that we can measure in quantities. Which quantities? We can measure in terms of mass, we can measure in terms of acceleration. Yes or no? So here in second law, it is relating force to the measurable quantities. In second law, we are relating force to the measurable quantities, which are there, mass of the body and acceleration generated in the body. Acceleration. So in first law, it is telling that force is required. So that is qualitative definition only. That is, force is required to bring the change in the state. Okay. In second, how we are going to relate this force to the change. Okay. How we are relating this force to the change, how we are going to measure how much is force required to bring the particular change, or if particular force is required, what amount of change it will bring, we can measure. So second law is providing us quantitatively, that is, we can measure the quantity. Quantitatively, you can say, we can measure the quantity. That is, if force is given, that is, this much force is being applied, mass of the body we know, we can calculate how much change it is going to bring in the velocity. That is, how much change in the momentum, we can measure that, okay? Or if mass is given and acceleration produced by that force is provided, we can calculate how much force was required, how much force was applied, we can calculate. So here we are going to measure the amount of force. So in first law, it can only tell us that force is required to bring that change, that's all. Okay. Now in second law, we are going to measure that force. We are going to measure that force, we can measure that change. So in first law, it is qualitatively explanation. Second law, it is quantitatively explaining. That is, we can measure that quantity of force, we can measure the quantity of change brought. Understood now? This is the difference between first law and second law. Okay, so to first law, we have moved to the second step. Okay, that is, we can measure that force. Okay, this is clear.
Okay, yes.
Now, for example, we have already discussed. Okay, so for example, we are having a body M. Okay, a body of mass M. Okay, we have applied force. Okay, and acceleration produced in the body is 5 m/s². Okay, this example is given in book as well. We applied some force on the body and acceleration produced is 5 m/s². Okay, the same body we are taking, same body, this time again force is applied, F2 force, earlier it was F1. Now acceleration produced is 10 m/s². Okay, initially when I applied force F1, acceleration produced was 5 m/s. Now we have applied force F2 and acceleration produced is 10 m/s². Okay. So can you compare the forces? How these two forces are related?
F2 is more stronger force than F1.
Okay. Okay, that is fine. But how they are related? It means I have doubled the force. We have doubled the force. What we are going to see, that is F2 equal to 2F1. We have doubled the force, acceleration is doubled. Yes, we have doubled the force. It means the acceleration produced in the body is proportional to what?
Force.
Okay. We can infer that acceleration produced in the body is proportional to the force. If we increase the force, acceleration is going to increase. Okay, if I double the force, acceleration will be doubled. If I triple the force, acceleration will be tripled. Understood the proportional? So this acceleration produced in the body is dependent on force. It is dependent on force. So this is our independent quantity that we are applying. According to the force applied, what is produced? Acceleration. So acceleration produced in the body is directly proportional to the force applied on the body. This is clear? This is our force. Okay. We are going to derive Newton's first law. That is, we are going to derive F equal to ma. Okay, this equation we are going to derive. Okay, this is Newton's first law. Force applied to the body is equal to the product of the mass of the body and acceleration produced in the body, provided that mass is constant. There are those all conditions we'll discuss afterwards. Okay, so this thing is clear. Acceleration produced in the body is directly proportional to the force applied. Okay. Now, second, this time we are varying the masses. Acceleration produced is same. For example, acceleration is 2 m/s². Here as well, acceleration produced to be is 2 m/s². Okay. It means there is a body, for example, this is mass M, this is 2M mass. Okay. Now, we are having a body of mass M, we are having a body of mass 2M, that is double the mass. And we have to produce this much change. Okay. Acceleration has to be 2 m/s. Acceleration has to be 2 m/s. So how much force is required? This time I apply force F1 and F2. So this time what we are seeing here, mass is constant. We are assuming that one. First body is of mass M. Second body is of mass 2M. And we have to bring the same change. That is, if they are having some initial velocity, their final velocity after some time must be also same. For the same time period, we have to apply the force on the both the bodies, okay? Now, how much force is required? This time we are calculating how much force is required to bring change in to bring acceleration of 2 meter per second. To bring acceleration of 2 meter per second in a body of mass m. Okay. Secondly, how much force is required to bring acceleration of 2 meter per second or to generate acceleration of 2 meter per second in a body of mass 2m. Okay.
This sir, time, in F2 we have to give double force then F1.
Double force, yes. So see here, this force is dependent on what? To bring the same change. This force mass. Is dependent mass. On mass.
Mass.
This time, our force is dependent on mass. That is, force required to bring the same change in two different bodies is proportional to their masses. So to bring the change in a body, to bring the change in the body.
Time.
Okay, just few seconds I'll take. What is this? Force is dependent on mass of the body. To bring the some change in the body, force depends on mass. First, acceleration depends on the force applied. Acceleration produced in the body is proportional to the force applied. Here, force applied to bring the change is dependent on mass. Okay, this is clear. And when we combine these two equations, okay, we'll discuss them in detail. Okay, F is proportional to ma. Okay, we'll discuss those all afterwards. Okay, have you understood these things? Graphs as well, we have to draw. Okay, we'll discuss those graphs tomorrow. So these two points we are going to discuss again. They are important. Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You are going to get the link around 3 p.m. You may get it earlier as well. That will depend on as I get the free. Okay. So at 3 p.m. you can check. Any time you can appear during the day. Any time during the day.
Same.
Till 9 p.m. it will be available.
Take online. Okay, sir, up to which time you take online classes? Sir, up to 1 p.m. or 2 p.m.?
Today I'll get free at 12:20. Usually school time is 1 p.m. So today I'm getting free at 12:20. Okay. So any trouble if arises, you can contact me on WhatsApp. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, okay.
So
sir.
Check.
Thank you, sir.
I'll put a message in WhatsApp. Okay. Just check that one. Okay. Afterwards.
Yes, sir.
Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you